Eve is a sick nigga, ladies and gentlemen. Before we get started, like, YouTube.
Right there. Hey, man. Y'all see, I'm dressed up. I'm here to report live. You know what I'm saying? It's the Brammy. You know what I'm saying? It's an award show. So I'm dressed
up. Reporting live from Freeport.
You feel me? Live, baby. You know where I'm at. You know what I'm saying? It's the Brammy. Big B's, you know what I'm saying? I'm here. I'm representing the best. Know how. You know what I'm saying? In this fucking, what they call this, a Luther jacket, whatever. I'm out here outside with mine.
A what jacket?
It's called
whose jacket? A Luther jacket.
Luther Vandross.
Like Luther Vandross.
Luther Cole, Luther jacket, Luther Vandross, Luther Reigns. I don't give a damn. You know what I'm saying? I'm here to report live.
Batman, let's do it. Brammy Awards, 5th annual, last episode of the year. Let's do it.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The strongest, the fastest, the roughest, the toughest, the quickest, the greatest.
The almighty. Hero.
I'm the blueprint, and I am the legit boss.
Feel this glow!
Can you dig it?
New day!
Worldwide!
Hold on a minute, player.
We are the nation of domination.
Oh, my brother, testify!
We want the smoke!
You're rocking with the number one wrestling podcast in the game, the Black Announce Table Podcast, featuring Sky High Eve, Cody Dre, and Ms. Suku.
Bing bong.
Oh, that's
bing bong.
Look, man, y'all seen I'm. I feel like, you know how Steve Harvey be on ABC? That's how I feel right now, you know what I'm saying, for the New Year.
On ABC?
Yeah, will you be on ABC for the New Year's?
I don't know. Steve Harvey got a lot of jobs. I can't
not
keep up.
Not up with Steve Harvey.
Look like Steve Harvey with that boy.
Niggas about to roast me. Fuck out of here.
Man, I love it though. We here. 5th annual. We here. Brammy Awards. Shouts out to E for being in character. You know what I'm saying?
Come on, man.
It's lovely.
I told y'all I'm here to report, man. Feel me?
I love it, man.
I got some special juice. You know what I'm saying? This is the celebratory juice right here. Feel me? Strictly. Feel me? Got a little bit of that in this cup right here. Salute to Zell. I'm ready, man. Come on. End of the year, we got to celebrate.
You're right.
I can't believe it. Like, this year flew by so fast. I'm like, bro, how is there already another new year? Like, I'm ready for it, but I'm just like, sheesh.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm ready for this new year too. Pack this year up. This year wasn't that bad. I can't front. Like, it wasn't. I feel like, you know, this year, like, niggas got some wins in this year.
Definitely.
It wasn't as bad as last year because, you know, we had a little more freedom and shit, but I feel like we got some more wins, too.
No, we definitely got some wins in, snuck some wins in, so they say. How was you guys' this Christmas? Christmas just passed, you know what I mean? How was this? Was y'all in the spirit for Christmas?
No,
Christmas was I can't front. Christmas was it did not feel like Christmas. One, because it was on a Saturday. Two, everybody got COVID, so it was like, you feel, my sister got it, my cousin, my nephews, fucking uncles, aunts, nieces, you feel me? So everybody got COVID, everybody's sick, so it's like, damn, you can't really be around the family, you feel me? My mom didn't really want to cook nothing because it was like, ain't nobody coming over, what's the point? But you know, it was all right. It was, for what it was okay. Sat back, watched some basketball games.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I got a present. Oh, shit. I got a fucking present. You know what I'm saying? I got a brand new microphone. I got the legit shit too. Wait till I hook the mic stand and everything up.
Yeah, what?
2022, I'm going crazy.
Nice.
Yeah.
So I'm about to go nuts. 2022. Stupid, man.
But yeah, same thing like Eve said. I mean, like, it just didn't really feel like, it didn't feel like Christmas. Like, my mom was working too that day, so like she wasn't there, and it's like, you know, like they have like a, my family does like this whole little cute thing where like my parents will, even as old as we are, they still do that. They do that for all of us, and it's still like really cute. And like my dad did it, but he did it like super late, like in the morning. Like I was already up. He was like kind of giving me, you know, like putting it together still. But it just wasn't the same because, like, you know, like I said, my mom wasn't there, and like my family came over and stuff. But it was just, you know, it was just small. It wasn't nothing crazy. It didn't feel, you know, as jolly and as grand as it usually does. Nah, my mom didn't even make any sorrow. She didn't make no ginger beer. She didn't make no sweet bread. Like, she just made some regular bread and ham. That was it.
Damn.
Damn. What about you, Cody?
Yeah, nah, I understand. I completely understand. I had a pretty good Christmas, you know. I was all over the place, but it was good. Like before I went out, I had went to went back home, and I just checked in with my family, my girl's family, and before we left, we had our little, had to open our presents here and stuff. So that was cool. You know what I'm saying? First Christmas together and everything, and our place and everything. That was cool. But like you guys said, it just, it was something about it that was missing. It just wasn't all the way there.
It was the spirit, bro. The Christmas spirit. It's not there.
Yeah, man.
The Omarion variant took it.
Yeah, man.
That's what happened.
That's wild.
What'd you get?
Oh man, I got I got some new earrings. I got some nice ass earrings. I got a lot of clothes. I got a wallet. I got a lot of stuff. It's way a lot. I got this backpack, this book bag. I got mad stuff, son. I got this HomePod. I got a lot of shit. I'm like, yes, this is lit.
You know what I'm saying? HomePod, that's fire.
Hell yeah.
What'd you get, Chris?
I got a bunch of stuff. I got a bunch of clothes. I got a little, I got a cropped North Face bubble jacket. So fire. Ugh, can't wait to wear it. I got a, what do you call it? Blow drying like brush thing. So it's like, it's just like a brush, but it does like the same effects like as a blow dryer. So it's like really easy to like blow out your hair. So I'm excited to use that too. I got a lot of stuff from Skims. Rob got me a bunch of stuff from the Skims Fendi collection. So that was cute. But yeah, I got a lot of shit. Perfume, you know. Regular little cute girly shit that I'm into. I got a couple jackets too. Shane got me like this little fuzzy jacket. So yeah,
that's what's up. When you get older, I'm starting to realize that Christmas is more about like, I don't know, the joy is kind of in like giving, you know what I'm saying? So it's like,
yeah, the
like,
joy is definitely in giving.
Hell yeah.
When you get to little kids, you see them, you feel me? It's like, damn, like I just cashed out at fucking Dollar Tree, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna give you some bullshit right now. You're having the time of your life, you know what I'm saying?
Can I start a dollar? Yo.
Nigga, I spent $4. Like, best investment of my life. Look at you going crazy. Coloring books, crayons, cookies, all types of shit. You know what I'm saying? $15 for myself. That's just amazing. I bought my dad some shit. I got him like a Home Depot gift card. My dad is really tough to shop for. Like, I realized that this year. Because I was like, damn, like, what do I get my pops? Like, I went to the mall. I was like, do I get him a polo sweater? Do I get him some new shoes? Like, I was like, nah, let me go to Home Depot, bro. because I
what he really wants.
Yeah, just get him some Home Depot bucks, whatever the fuck. You feel me? I'll put some shit on a card. Boom. Gave it to my, served it up like some papers. Here you go, bro. Gave it to him. He was happy. I got my mom some Ugg slippers. She was cool. Cute. Bought my girl some new nip pods. Like everybody was everybody happy in the hood. You feel me? So,
Gucci. Yeah, I got my dad some Birkenstocks. So he was happy.
He gonna go, crazy.
That's like West Indian man, love a slipper, bro. I was like, Dad, there's like fur inside of it. So, you know, like, and that's exactly what I told him. I'm like, in the summertime, don't let me catch you in the backyard gardening with them shits on. I was and he's like, started laughing already. I'm like, I know he gonna do that. I know he gonna do that. Last year, I got him Ugg slippers, and them shits is. They've been through a lot. I'm like, bro, you got them a year ago. Like, why do they look like this?
Dirt, that's why. You're planting in them shits, too.
A fact. He'd probably be, like, raking leaves and shit in his Ugg slippers.
Yo, speaking of slippers, my brother, I'm glad you said this. Speaking of slippers, so yesterday, obviously, I told y'all, you feel me? Right now, if y'all don't know, it's very hard to get COVID tests everywhere. The lines are extremely long, so I woke up 7 a.m. like a upstanding gentleman that I am. Get to the line. The shit is wrapped around the urgent care and down the block. So I'm standing there, you feel me, listening to content on the Patreon, patreon.com/blackannouncetable, spend the $5, you know what I'm saying? So I'm listening to our content, you know what I'm saying, making sure everything's good. Get to the front of the line. Shorty's like, oh, you're signed in, you feel me? So look out for the text message. And you could come back. You feel me? You get it 30 minutes before. So I was like, all right, well, how long you think this is going to take? Shorty said 6 hours. Hold on. Let me hit the drop. Oh, shit. Shorty said 6 hours, son. I was like, all right, well, if that's the case, I'm going to just go ahead. I need to get an oil change anyways. I'm going to go to the dealership, change the oil. They're going to service me up. 2 hours, because usually it's 2 hours. You know what I'm saying? I got 2 hours to kill. Go there, go home, take a nap, boom, come back. I get to Honda at 9:30. I don't leave until 3 o'clock. Them niggas took 5 hours to do an oil change on my car. You feel me? I was tight. You feel me? I was pissed. But there was one moment that made it all worth it. You know what I'm saying? And this is why I said slippers. I seen a Haitian man walk into Honda in the service center. My son had on a Gucci scarf, a Dior sweater, some tight fucking pants, and guess what he had on his feet?
Slippers.
This nigga had on open toe. Yo. This nigga had on slippers. All of his toes.
Not open toe, though, like, bro.
Open toe. All his toes were closed. My son had all five of his toes showing, foot out. I was like, boy, it's 42 degrees out here. I was like, why are you doing, you know what I'm saying? Like, come on, bro. I was like, why are you doing this to me? You know what I'm saying? Not even to yourself. Like, you got me looking at your big toe.
That's different. That's different.
Nigga had the nerve to have on a scar. I'm like, bro, you protecting everything but your feet? Like, come on. I don't know, what's
that's
happening?
Hilarious because your feet is the first thing to get cold when you're like outside.
Son, I guess not to that nigga because that nigga had all his toes exposed.
That's big dog.
Facts, making big noise.
Yeah, that's big dog, man.
But yeah, that right there. That was the wildest shit I ever seen, bro. I can't even catch on a scarf, sweater. He was bundled up from head to the foot. And then he just let it hang. Pause.
Hey, yo. Say nah. But yeah, nah.
I gotta play this one.
My table.
Yo, you just gonna play another one. I was about to say, yeah, last one of the year. Let it fly. Let that drop fly.
I got one of it. I got to clean it up, though. Feel me? Anyway.
Yeah, man.
Back. Just unmute your mic for us, Queen.
Oh. We're back.
God.
Word.
Loud ass mic.
Word.
What happened?
Your mic loud as shit.
Oh. Is it better now?
No. That was better, I think. That's definitely better.
What did you say? Is it better now?
Yeah, it's better now.
Okay.
No.
That's so weird, though. It's usually always on that setting, so I don't even know why it sounded much louder when I came back.
Man, look.
Like, I always have it turned all the way up.
Turn that shit all the way down, please. Oh, nigga, they almost went deaf.
Is it still super loud?
Nah, you good now.
Got the first album, Meek Mill, Mike. Nigga. Meek was screaming. Got the goddamn Kuda 6ix9ine, Mike.
It's sad because I don't know how much I got left in here. I've been drinking this shit for a year, legit. Feel me? Through the good times and the bad. Oh, we good.
Wow.
Shit crazy, bro. Shit crazy. Oh, did you get your tickets or nah?
Nah, I didn't get them yet.
Damn, I'm gonna hit son up tomorrow.
I didn't get them.
Well, he did say by like Thursday, so if you don't get them by Thursday, then
tickets for what?
This nigga here. I won a raffle to get tickets to day one. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, damn, like, I was like, really and truly, I was like, I know I'm not going to day one. You feel me? I don't live in Georgia. So I was like, if I win, I was like, I'm going to give them to Cody. You know what I'm saying? Because he out there. He could go have fun, him and Jazz. You could come back with some, you feel me? You might be able to record some shit, throw it up. You feel me?
Yeah.
You might have an experience to talk about when you come back. So I was like, if anything, you could go. Should be Gucci. And I ended up winning, so nigga hit me up. I was like, oh, shit. Hit Cody up. I was like, yo.
Man.
Nice.
Look at you. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, that was dope. I didn't expect them to hear that. I was like, oh, shit. Like, I ain't going to hold you. I wasn't going to go to day one because of what's going on. But, like, I mean, I don't have to go if I got some tickets going around. It's like
for free.
I gotta go. So yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, man. Once again, I really appreciate that.
No doubt, man. I gotta make sure the team happy. You feel me? Make sure everybody good. Everybody straight. You feel me? Oh shit! I'm over here knocking this mic down. But anyways. It's the Brammys, ladies and gentlemen. You feel me? Y'all, look, if y'all don't know, what's this, the fifth annual?
Fifth annual.
Good God, look at that. You feel me? Five of them things. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
We're going to give out some awards. We're going to clap it up. We're going to make some noise. And we're going to end the year the right way.
A smile.
World with a fucking coconut smile, you know what I'm saying? So, shit, without further ado, let's get to it, man.
All right, we're gonna get to it, but
my fault, OG.
We mentioned day one,
mm-hmm.
So before we get into the Brammys, we might as well just give some predictions, you know what I'm saying? Might as well, we here. I'll throw it up on the screen, we give our predictions.
We're here.
Get right into the awards and all of that. So I have it up right here and I'm going to bring it up right now. Viewers on YouTube, y'all see the card right there. Hold on, let me move it up a little bit. Boom, boom. All right. Without further ado, Chris.
All right. Day one. Let's go. First match on the card, we have Big E versus Seth Rollins versus Kevin Owens versus Bobby Lashley in a fatal four-way for the WWE Championship. Interesting. Who do we have? Who you got?
I got the Omicron virus. None of them niggas going to be there.
Jesus.
Bing bong.
I can't.
Yo, wait, hold on. Before we go any further, Eve, if you set me up, man, I go there and I see a Sami Zayn Nakamura main event. I swear. I just thought about that. They taking niggas off the card and everything, man. Come on.
They pulled Big E, Seth Rollins, and I think Bobby Lashley from the house show. They pulled somebody else. I think Becky Lynch.
Oh.
From the MSG house shows, but I guess it was COVID protocol, so I don't know if they will be there or not. You know, CDC talking, you feel me, 5 days, you feel me, you could get back outside, get back to it, you know, so who knows. I got Big E retaining though, if he's there.
We'll see.
I got Big E as well.
Yeah, same. Okay, cool. So we're all going with Big E. Next on the card, we have Roman Reigns versus Brock Lesnar for the Universal Championship. You already know I got Roman always.
Yeah, I got Big Romanowski also.
I would have to agree.
Y'all have.
Big dog.
Okay. Ain't nobody
next on the card, right? We have the Usos. Yeah, it's not happening. Next on the card, we have the Usos versus the New Day in a tag team SmackDown Championship match. I didn't realize that the Usos are still champs. That's crazy.
I got the Usos.
I'm rolling with the Usos.
I got
Cody.
Man, these niggas gonna face each other to forever. I got the Usos as well. Fuck it.
The end of time.
What?
Oh boy. This is very interesting. We picking the same thing. Okay. I got Edge.
Yeah, I didn't even hear you announce the shit, but.
You didn't hear me announce it? Okay, let me say it again. We have next on the card, we have Edge versus The Miz in a singles match. I got Edge.
Oh, yeah, nah, big Edge. Miz ain't winning.
I got the Miz.
Ooh. Interesante.
I'm about to retain my shit.
I got more surprises to come, but all right.
Ooh. Okay, next on the card, we have Becky Lynch, champ, versus Liv Morgan for the Raw Women's Championship. I got Becky retaining.
I know Liv got a hive right now, but let me tell y'all something. It ain't happening. Becky Lynch.
It's Becky Lynch all the way. Come on. Let's be real.
Figures. Okay. Next on the card, we have Drew McIntyre versus Madcap Moss in a singles match. Drew McIntyre.
Hey, man, look at Drew McIntyre's fall from grace, man. Look at this shit right here.
Relax.
You can face a Madcap Moss.
Cody rolling in his grave.
I'm alive. I'm here. Hi.
Facing a nigga named Madcap. I don't know.
Nigga named Madcap.
This match better be 2 minutes long.
I ain't gonna hold you. Fact. I got Madcap Moss winning.
Cody, you're not even trying this time, huh?
I'm out of here.
Nah, like, cause they going. It's I know where they going. He gonna end up. McIntyre gonna end up feuding with Corbin, and they gotta continue this shit. Come on, son. Like, why is this there? Why is this here? Like, really?
That's a good question. Why is this here?
Yeah, that's. But yeah, I think Madcap Moss gonna get a little fluke victory or something like that.
Or just some, well, I'm gonna tell you right now, you're thinking wrong. But I'm rolling. next and finally on the card, Madcap Moss.
Nah, that's the first.
I'm going out, man. So I got to do something. Eve, oh, you've been holding on. You've been keeping my title hostage. I need to do something. Ooh, I got to.
They could pick a nigga named Madcap. That's about to keep my shit.
Okay. Next and finally, we have RK-Bro versus the Street Profits for the Raw Tag Team Championship.
I don't see RK-Bro coming off those belts anytime soon, so I got them.
Yeah. I would have to agree.
Yeah.
And that's it for day one, you guys.
I was
Thanks
to
for coming to my TED Talk.
I have a match of the night.
Match of the night?
Yeah, what y'all think the best match going to be on this card? Ooh.
To me, I think probably Roman and Brock. Because that's just what I'm interested in, but you know.
I would agree. What happened to I guess they doing the Sami Zayn Nakamura match on SmackDown.
Probably.
I guess. But yeah. But yeah. I would have to agree. Roman and Brock.
I think the Fatal 4-Way might be the best match. Either that or, yeah, no, I think that one. Either that one or the Roman and Brock match. Either one.
The thing about the Fatal 4-Way is, like, I guess what they're doing to, like, build it up is not as – I'm not anticipating that as much, and I guess, like, that's why I'm sleeping on it. Mm-hmm. But I hope they go out there and knock it out the park. And, it, like, you got four competitors that's obviously capable of doing so, but mm-hmm. I guess it's just the build for me. That's, I'm not really on that, but yeah, that makes sense.
I can agree with that.
All right, man. And with that being said, got the day one predictions out of the way. We can give them what they came for, man. The Brammy Awards. Let's start this thing. First off, before we start, we have as we play the nominees, it's a listener's choice. Listener's choice is the wild card. Listeners had a chance to be heard, and we gave them a slot on the nominees, regardless of promotion. So it could be like we usually do WWE wrestlers and stuff. Mm-hmm. But we got some listener's choices in the topics. That's AEW. It might be a match or so from NXT. Like, it's from anywhere. Just added on into the nominees. Just giving y'all that heads up. And with that being said, let's go into the first award of the night, Tag Team of the Year.
Nominees for Tag Team of the Year. New Day, Listener Choice, Lucha Bros, Usos, RK Bro.
That's that. Salute to the production team. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man.
That's a fact.
That was great.
It's a shame because I forgot the tag teams already. Can you run that back?
Nominees for Tag Team of the Year: New Day, Listener Choice, Lucha Bros, Usos, RK Bro,
that's that shit right there, boy. She hot.
Oh man, see, I don't want to be the one to do it,
but I must say some off the wall shit because you already picked Madcap Moss. You must say some bullshit right now.
I really don't want to give a. I mean, I'm happy we got the listener's choice because an AEW team should win this award.
Who are you gonna say, FTR?
Hell no. Hell no. I would definitely say Lucha Bros. I mean, they had the best match, tag team match, this year. I mean, I'm going to have to go with the listener's choice. I'm picking the listener's choice. Fuck it.
You know, I'm not mad at the listener's choice. I feel like AEW is a tag team wrestling show. You know what I mean? So it's very fitting to be fair to the listeners and agree. So I'm going to agree. I'm going to agree with the listeners, and y'all can have this one. So Lucha Bros for me too. I would say
that's crazy. Hey, man. Can you play them choices one more time for me?
Hell no.
No, I'm fucking
sir,
around.
Do you have short-term memory loss?
Lucha Bros definitely deserve to win this award from the matches I've seen from them this year. Yes, I have seen Lucha Bros matches, contrary to popular belief. I think popular. It's this juice right here, y'all. You know what I'm saying?
talking like
Shannon Sharp. I got the heavy tongue right now.
Hey, yeah, yo. Nah.
All right.
Nigga got on the podcast talking about you got the heavy tongue, right? Yo, come on, son.
Yo. Close, you know what I'm saying?
Macho boy!
Lucha Bros.
All right, man. Let's give it up for the Lucha Bros, man. Yes. Shout out to the Lucha Bros taking home the first Brammy of the night.
Facts.
Yes. Yes. And with that,
look at us, growth.
I'm surprised. Look, man, I love it.
Although, do you have news and rumors?
No.
We are in the middle of the award show.
I got something to shit on for sure. Don't let this shirt and tie and suit fool you. I'm wearing ball shorts underneath this shit. I'm ready to get I got on Nike.
Eve, are you dressed like a Zoom call right now? Like you just have on like basketball shorts on the bottom and just a shirt and a tie on and a jacket?
100%. I got on Nike shorts and Crocs underneath this right here. It stops here at the waist.
You gotta love it.
Yeah, man. This nigga's a legend.
A true work from home professional right here.
Yes, moving right along with the Brammy Awards. Let's go into our second award of the night for best ring gear.
And the nominees for best ring gear: Bianca Belair, Listener Choice, Pentagon Jr., Sasha Banks, Big E,
hey.
MB's, hey, I want to start rapping over these shit. MB's hot.
Hey, yo, Eve, I played a baby, dumb. That's true. Right. Oh, man. Damn.
This one is tough for me.
It's between Bianca and Sasha.
Sasha's ring gear is fire. You feel me? You can see the inspiration, you feel me, in different, you know, gear that she has, whether it be like, it might be like some Marvel inspired shit, some Eddie Guerrero inspired shit. You know what I'm saying? It's dope. It's fire. But Bianca's gear, she makes herself.
You know, I was just going to say that Bianca makes her own gear. Like, she every little thing is like,
she does everything on her own. So it's tough. You know what I'm saying? Biggie also has dope gear too. You feel me? He got a lot of hip hop inspired gear. His latest gear is inspired by Seinfeld. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I'm surprised New Day, Kofi and Woods, I'm surprised they wasn't in here. Because they had some hot shit too.
Yeah, it's like the same thing.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it to Bianca because she makes her own shit.
Same. I was just going to say that.
We all agree. We all agree there. And Eve said it. Eve broke it down for you. And that's it. So big shouts out to Bianca Belair. Bianca Belair takes home best ring gear, and I'm pretty sure that won't be her only Brammy on the night.
No, of course it can't be. I told y'all, remember Michael Jackson won 28 Grammys? That nigga was holding them shits like this, like kids? Yeah.
It was in the video package. It was in the video package already, so...
Facts. Hey, look, if y'all are listening to this, make sure y'all go on YouTube and watch it as well. I promise it's an experience. You know what I'm saying? Subscribe also if you haven't already. Go over there and make sure y'all watch this shit, man. It's some good stuff. I didn't wear a shirt and a tie and a Luther Reigns jacket for no reason. Please.
Yes, you got to be in on the inside jokes. Facts. Mostly YouTube. Gave out the award for best ring gear and...
Oh, before we move on, Sasha Banks, if you see this, you feel me? I think, I might have said this before, but I think Sasha Banks needs to come out with her own line of cat suits and thigh-high boots. I think them shits were so crazy. Because every, like, cat suit or bodysuit that I ever seen Sasha Banks in, and where she got the thigh-high boots, she'd be looking fire, you know what I'm saying? So, Sasha Banks, let this be a business endeavor for you in the future. You know what I'm saying? Body suits and thigh-high boots.
You know the fucking vibes?
I don't like the apple, so that's my shit right there. But we can continue.
I agree 100%. From best ring gear, and here on the Black Announce table, we're going to give you the worst ring gear. Mm. And here we go.
Nominees for Worst Ring Gear: Angelo Dawkins, Listener Choice, Darby Allin, Keith Lee, Nikki Ash,
hey. No, wait, hold before.
I was definitely crying laughing.
Before y'all say anything, look, man, somebody, we already gave somebody two awards prior. If they win this year, that's their third worst ring gear of the Brammies. So the floor is y'all's.
Hey. This was a hard one because it's a lot of ass in the categories here. Everybody definitely deserves to be there. But
I'm surprised Hit Row wasn't up there.
Who?
Hit Row.
Mm.
Hit Row.
Oh, I didn't hear you.
I was about to say, did we forget about them already?
You don't want me to answer that.
No, we didn't forget about them.
Also, I think it would have been funny if it was if the shit hit and it was just like Angelo Dawkins and it came back to us like it was just him.
Yeah, because we was weak.
I was crying.
Choice number one off the rip.
Yeah, choice number one is I don't want to give it to Angelo, though, because I feel like, his outfits are bad, though.
It's okay, sister. You could do it.
Yikes.
Yeah, I'm going to have to give it to Angelo Dawkins.
Oh, Lord. Is that... And...
We don't know about it, though. We don't know. We the coach. Hey. Angelo, I'm gonna have to hit the red X on you for that one, man. Like, I'm gonna have to go ahead and give you that one too, brother, man. I'm sorry.
Damn, son.
Nah, cause you know why? Cause he dressed bad in the ring and outside the ring. I could at least explain why I'm giving you these, you feel me, these awards. You know what I'm saying? Like, how you dress bad in and outside? You know what I'm saying? Like, I understand if you dress bad, like, outside. You know what I'm saying? Because some people just don't know how to dress.
Mm-hmm.
But inside, it's like, damn, like, I'm a character. You know what I'm saying? Like, niggas could at least, like, why I'm, you know what I'm saying? But I seen this man wear a suit jacket with a hoodie and a snapback. I was like, nah, come on, bro. At a Nets game, I was like, nah, we can't do this.
This nigga just putting shit together, like, all right. Yeah, man. I'm sorry, man.
Go ahead.
Third year in a row? Or just third Brammy in this category, period?
He racking them shits up, I'll tell you that.
Boy, is he.
Bing bong.
Oh, soon it's going to be called the Angelo Dawkins Award.
This is, you know what, Chris? That's a great idea.
Right, that's what it's going to be called next year. Angelo, you got three of them. We're going to retire you from ever even just being nominated.
Yes.
This award is officially going to be named after you, the Angelo Dawkins Award.
As it should. Hey, as it should. Our terribly dressed king.
There you have it. Angelo Dawkins wins the award for worst dress. Let me give him some applause. It's triggered. Oh, wait, nah. That's the wrong one. I meant this one.
It is triggered.
It is triggered. It fit.
Oh, shit.
It fit.
Damn, nah, this probably the best Brammies we ever done had. You feel me, this?
Yes. We ain't no arguing. We just going along with it. So far, so good, man.
Word.
Look, man, let's go into this next category. We got the return of the year.
And the nominees for return of the year. Becky Lynch, Listener Choice. CM Punk. John Cena. Brock Lesnar.
Damn, these beats is fire. I'm over here rapping behind the scenes. Getting a couple bars off. All right, so what are we thinking?
This one is tricky, but not so much. I feel like it should go to CM Punk because it's just the most anticipated. You know, people have been waiting for years in all wrestling promotions to see him come back. The pop was crazy. You know, it was just probably the most talked about return, I feel like, personally, this year. Becky Lynch was also a big deal, too. But, you know, she had a baby. We knew she would come back eventually. But this one was very like, oh, shit. Like, oh, he's actually going to be on AEW. Okay. I would give it to CM Punk. I feel like it's well-deserved for him.
I would agree. I'll say this. Matter of fact, I ain't gonna shit on CM Punk today. I got a whole new year to shit on CM Punk, so I'm gonna leave you alone this one time. You got it.
CM Punk thanks you. I'm sure he does. yeah, man. It's no question in this category. CM Punk, in my opinion. But boy, if CM Punk wasn't here, it would have been tough. Because I enjoy.
I would have gave it to John Cena.
Probably gave it to Cena. Yeah.
Because I was going off the pops on the like on the return. You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking back. I'm like, the CM Punk pop was crazy. The Cena pop at Money in the Bank was crazy.
Mm-hmm.
The Brock pop was crazy too. When he come back at SummerSlam.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was crazy too. But we also
Becky's pop was crazy at WrestleMania too.
Yeah, she came back to SummerSlam also.
Oh, it was SummerSlam, yeah.
Yeah. Damn, not
it. She was crazy too.
Looking at it.
Well, if it wasn't CM Punk, for me personally, it would have probably been Becky Lynch, because I feel like she had like that huge pop. Like, people were losing their mind.
Yeah, you're right. Looking back at him, pause if need be. I might have to say Becky. You're right.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Because I'm scaling the props.
It was. But I feel like the and this is just the what happened after she returned kind of killed it for me. And we know what happened with Bianca. So it's like I'm kind of sour on that, but I definitely agree with the pop and everything. But this is just for me personally. It's just like after, I'm not a big fan of what happened afterward.
Neither am I.
Yeah.
But you know why also I would say Becky, because it wasn't expected. You know what I'm saying? Like we thought we was gonna get Sasha, you know what I'm saying? And then out comes Becky. So it's like, oh shit. So I'll probably roll Becky.
Okay, cool. But so shouts out to CM Punk. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, shouts to that too. I forgot who picked CM Punk as did the listeners. The listeners.
Oh.
It might have Jabbatism, if I remember correctly from seeing it. So
yeah.
Salute to that pick.
Moving right along now. This time, what are we going into? Let's go into the next Brammy. This one is Breakout Star. Which wrestler broke out and became a star, I guess.
And the nominees for Breakout Star: Bianca Belair, Listener Choice, Carmelo Hayes, Damian Priest, Reggie.
Who put Reggie on this list?
That's a fact. Reggie does not belong on this list.
I think it's going to be Bron Breakker, somebody. You know what I'm saying? That shit, Reggie smiling, man.
Reggie came in as Carmelo Lowe, you know what I mean? And then he out here doing flips, getting belts and shit. I'm like, all right, man.
Yeah.
I understand.
That's a fact.
I like
the listeners picking this one, actually.
Yeah, Carmelo Hayes.
He's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody else go first.
I don't know.
I'll go first.
This one I'm a little stumped. Yeah, go ahead.
Look, man. Breakout star this year, Royal Rumble win, WrestleMania win. It's Bianca Belair.
ESPYs, Soul Survivor, Survivor Series.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
Even though like Carmelo Hayes, breakout. Damian Priest haven't been pinned all year. Like
breakout.
It's like, and we
all
see
of these are great choices for real.
Yeah. It's tough, but
yeah, it literally comes down to like the accolades. So I'm glad that Cody, you know, brought that straight into the picture, because like he's saying, like literally everyone on the list, even Reggie, you know, literally broke out this year and, you know, did what needed to be done. And, you know, it's a big deal. It's a big deal for them to even be nominated, honestly. So that's good. But yeah, I would agree. Bianca
had a hell of a year, man. Start to finish. She been rolling. She got over on her own. You feel me? She ain't have to do no crazy shit to do. You feel me? The people love her. She loved. She what was that list we pulled up where she was like the fifth most tweeted about female athlete of 2021? Like, so, Bianca Belair, man, I think she deserves that for sure, for sure.
Definitely.
Absolutely.
And there you have it. Bianca Belair racks up another win tonight on the Grammy Awards.
Cheers. Cheers to you, Bianca. Okay, let's all do it. Ready? One, two, three. Hello, where the fuck are your cups? Okay.
Moving right along. This time we're going to go into the rivalry of the year. Who was going at it? Best feud. Back and forth.
And the nominees for rivalry of the year. Bianca versus Sasha. Listener choice. Omega versus Paige. Edge versus Rollins. Lesnar versus Reigns with Heyman.
You gotta stop playing beats.
I can hear sweat trickling down your cheek. Come on.
This one is another good one too. Another good category. And
you need
honestly, at the beginning, I thought it said robbery of the year. I was like, ooh, not robbery. For me, it would be a toss-up between Roman and Brock, and I guess Sasha and Bianca, even though their rivalry didn't really last that long. Whereas, like, Roman and Brock, like, is still ongoing.
So
Roman and Brock.
Okay. Bet.
For me, but what do you guys say? Maybe I'll change my mind.
I mean, you're not, like, you can't be wrong on these choices. It's like, you can't be. But Eve, go ahead.
I got Edge and Seth Rollins because we got three fire matches out of all three. We got a breaking and entering. You know what I'm saying? From Seth Rollins.
Which was fire.
You feel me? So, come on, man. Every match you have, you feel me, they get better. So I'm gonna
Eve, just stop lying. It's because Seth has broken. It was because of the breaking and entering.
I mean that right there was icing on the cake for me. You know what I'm saying? I love the little breaking and entering. You know what I'm saying? But the match is dope. So I'm gonna go with Edge and Seth.
I hate Eve. I really hate Eve because like I wanted to be the one to pick Edge and Seth because obviously it's Edge. But yeah, I have to agree, man. Like I really have to agree. And like each like the matches got better and better. The climax at the Hell in a Cell at Crown Jewel, talk about that match as in match of the year, more than likely. The breaking and entering. Didn't Edge give him a bloodbath, a brew bath too? It's like it was just so much, and they was just going back and forth. Matches got better and better, and everything. I gotta pick Edge and Seth on this one as well.
Yeah, so, I'm gonna have to change my choice and agree with you guys.
Yeah. And
come on, sister.
And the thing about Bianca and Sasha, like. It like the feud is just like it wasn't like is as intense as this was. You know what I'm saying? We ended
and
up
it wasn't
getting
long.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. Bianca won the Rumble, and obviously she goes on. You got to face the champ, so it's like cool. But this right here, how this started and the backstory with everything in this with Edge and yeah. So yeah, we're gonna give the award to Edge. And Seth Rollins. F- for feud of the year right there.
Most definitely.
And
what do we got next?
Female superstar of the year.
You ain't even got to play it. You feel me? Go ahead. I already know. Nah, I want to hear what beat. I'm about to rap, so go ahead and play
the beat. Nominees are for female superstar of the year: Bianca Belair, Listener Choice, Jade Cargill, Sasha Banks, Becky Lynch,
Bianca Belair.
Another one.
But I also do feel like this one kind of deserves an honorable mention too, because the ladies did go, you feel me, they was going crazy this year. So if y'all were to give an honorable mention, who would it be?
Good one, Eve. Shit caught me off guard. I mean, obviously Charlotte's not there. Charlotte, you could slide Charlotte in there. She put on some fire matches as well. Her match with Becky, her match with Rhea. She got some joints in there. Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of where it's at for me. It's kind of obvious for me, but
I'll probably go Charlotte as well.
I would have to go Charlotte. I mean, she's just a dominant force, like when it comes to the women's division, regardless. And it's like, you know, she's an important piece there. A lot of shit happens because of Charlotte. So it's like, at some point, you know, we always talk about giving people their flowers and everything. And like, I just think it's so important to give her flowers, because there aren't many athletes like her, you know what I mean? And like, she gives it up every time. Like, she's that girl, you know?
Yeah, I think Charlotte is, well, we've seen that shit don't really roll without Charlotte. You know what I'm saying? Like, you need Charlotte to get shit kind of rolling. You need that person to hate. You need that person to be, you feel me, that bitch. You know what I'm saying? And I say that respectfully. You know what I'm saying? So I'd have to go Charlotte.
But for female superstar of the year,
most definitely Bianca Belair, 100%. 100%. That's great.
And it's her third Brammy on the night. Congratulations, Bianca Belair.
Yeah. Bianca clearing house.
Ping pong.
She's racking up. She's racking up. From the females, take it to the fellas. Male superstar of the year.
And the nominees for Male Superstar of the Year: Roman Reigns, Listener Choice, Adam Page, Bobby Lashley, Big E.
Easily, it's Roman Reigns. I don't care about what these guys say. The award goes to Roman Reigns. So, yes. The greatest heel, the cutest heel, the hottest male wrestler we've ever seen in our lives. You are a blessing, and I love you. And congratulations. We can move on.
I don't like that.
Do you guys have any words that you want to give Roman Reigns?
I got you right here.
Congratulations! Oh my God.
No. Look, man. I'm going to say this. Big E. Money in the Bank. WWE Champion.
Intercontinental champion.
All good for second place, man. All good for second place this year behind Roman Reigns.
Yes. Certainly.
As much as, like, you know what I mean? The matches, the whole SmackDown being built around the storyline and everything, and longest reign, and, well, on his way to the longest Universal Championship reign, it's like, come on.
Boy going crazy, man. You feel me? He's literally been championed from January 1st to January 1st. So I got to give it to him.
I mean, shouts out to Roman Reigns.
Unanimous.
Yes, sir.
Unanimous MVP right there.
Let's take it into the next Grammy Award. We got Match of the Year.
And the nominees for Match of the Year: Banks versus Belair at Mania. Listener Choice: Edge versus Rollins at Crown Jewel. Walter versus Dragunov at TakeOver. Roman versus DV versus Edge at Mania.
I think all of those matches listed made my personal top five matches of the year. So I'm not mad at any one of these choices, to be honest. The only match that didn't make it was Roman Reigns. I had Roman Reigns versus Daniel Bryan on SmackDown. That was my fifth choice. But all of my matches of the year is here. So this is going to be tough. This is definitely going to be tough. I'm interested in hearing what you guys think.
This one is tough.
Yeah, this one is tough. I would say for me, it's between Bianca and Sasha at Mania. And, well, it's three, because the Crown Jewel match with Edge and Seth Rollins was pretty fire as well. And then I do, you know, I really do still like the triple threat with Roman, Edge, and DB, the Stack'em, whatever.
Smash and Stack'em
became of that. But,
yeah.
I don't know. Smack'em, Stash'em, Smash'em. I don't know what the fuck. I'm going to go with my girl. I'm going to go with my girls. I'm going to go with Sasha and Bianca on this one.
Fuck it, man. Let's give Bianca another one, man. Go ahead. Keep it on the head, man. Go ahead.
Only
man.
Because of the moment, you know? The moment meant a lot. The moment, the feels, everything, it meant a lot. You know, like...
I agree. You ain't going to have no disagreements from me.
Disagreements.
You know what gets me, man? It's the very beginning where they both, like, Bianca's crying, Sasha tried out to break character. It was that for me. Yeah. It's just like,
exactly. They could have
walked in and rolled on the floor with each other. And I would have been like, yo, this shit fire. Like... Like, nah, it was that for me. It's like, come on, man.
Yeah. You can't deny it.
Yeah.
You can't deny it, man.
They performed. It's not even just, it's like, yo, they went out there and put on main event WrestleMania. It's like, I can't, two black women in the main event. I can't.
Mm-hmm.
I would be wrong.
Exactly.
Regardless of how great these other matches are as well. I'd be wrong not to. So
I remember saying this. I think we did like an after show with the enemies, the public enemies, and I remember saying, when you think of like a marquee match, like a main event match, WrestleMania match, that is the kind of match that you want. You know what I'm saying? The match that you wait for all night, the match that everybody's waiting to see. That is the match that, you know what I'm saying, that chef's kiss, that payoff. You know what I'm saying? That you go home happy. Mm-hmm. That's the main event that you want to see from a WrestleMania. So, Bianca Belair, congratulations, baby. You know what I'm saying? What's
and
that?
Sasha.
Yes.
My full session, but you feel thousand pardons.
That's for Bianca. And congratulations to Sasha as well. We got two more awards left. We're going to take it to Moment of the Year.
And the nominees for Moment of the Year: Banks versus Belair at Mania. Listener Choice: Gage getting choked out. Bad Bunny at Mania. Big E becomes WWE Champion.
I regret doing this show. I regret doing this show, man. I didn't know it was going to be like this. I really didn't.
Sasha Banks, man, go ahead and go ahead and get another one.
Get another one. That's what's that, five now?
Come on down, Sasha. I don't make the rules, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, our explanation for why deserves match of the year goes right into why this is the moment of the year.
Exactly. It comes full circle.
Hey. After that, you get another one.
Yeah, man. Also, shouts out to Big E as well. But
facts. Man. I can't front. Close, you feel me? Honorable mention, very close second is Gage getting his ass choked out. You feel me?
That's a fact.
Because you know, you feel me?
Kid, Bobby Lashley doing some straightening.
100%. You feel me? Kids need disciplining. Oh, my fault. Kids need some straightening. And that's what Gage got. You know what I'm saying? So
there we have it. It's your moment of the year. Bianca Belair versus Sasha Banks at WrestleMania. And we cruise right into our last Brammy of the night, which is Superstar of the Year. This should be good.
We got nominees for Superstar of the Year: Roman Reigns, Listener Choice, Edge, Big E, Bianca Belair.
That shit hot. Hold on, run that back one more time. We hear that one.
You was hot.
I was about to say, hollow shaking in this
position. I just want to say that this photo of Roman Reigns is amazing. I love this photo. That's all I wanted to say.
So we got, it was Roman, it was Bianca,
Big E, Edge.
And wait, hold on. Before we go any further, KP, I see the listener's choice was Edge, and I see you ain't put who suggested that, because them niggas was wrong as shit for putting Edge in this damn category. So KP tried to save y'all. So thank KP for me not getting on your ass about that pick. But yeah. Shit. Superstar.
So I will say, I will propose that maybe we should give this one to Big E, because he has also had a hell of a year, as we've said. And, you know, Bianca already has a lot of awards. Roman has a couple as well. I feel like it's only right to show some love to Big E. He's done a lot. I want to always give him his flowers. And, you know, we've been asking for this, actually, for a very long time. We've been asking for Big E to get this push. And he got it. So, what do you guys say?
Bianca Belair, come on down, baby. come get you one more. You
know? Oh my God. Hey, this man is biased. This guy is biased over here.
I do not make the rules.
Well, Biggie, I tried.
I'm playing. Who do y'all? Let's talk about this. This is the last one. Let's debate.
Yeah, this is definitely got. I seen where everybody.
Let's debate this one.
And Chris, you make a great point for Biggie. You really do. I have to go Roman. After all the awards we just gave Bianca and everything, what Roman, him being champ the whole year, him putting on matches, Roman is in like three of my top five matches. Like, oh, and like if I make a top 10 list, he's in there even more. It's like, as much as we are proud for Bianca and the come up she's had and the incredible year she's having, that boy on SmackDown, that tribal chief still running shit whole year. Title reign still there.
Ask about him.
What's the fact?
You know, I will never go against the tribal chief. I just wanted to shine a light on Big E and see if maybe he could get one, but it's not really looking like it.
But, you ain't give Big E one of them? I could
have
sworn
Big E.
I could
have
sworn Big E got one at least.
Nope.
He didn't get one?
I don't think so.
Nope.
No, he got an honorable mention too for the ring gear.
So what's the word? Both y'all saying Roman?
Yeah.
Nah.
Are you changing your mind on Roman?
You want to give it to Bianca.
So I do. Well, I wanted to close out with six.
You're not wrong. It's just like,
hey, all right, you know what? Who else picked up Doudrop this year?
Roman, just kidding. you're right. That's my case right
there. Bianca's stronger than Roman. That's a fact. That. I don't know why Roman was on that pound for pound strongest superstar list last week we did either, but carry on.
Well, man, that's a different story for a different day, but I seen Bianca Belair lift up Doudrop for a KOD with my own eyes.
We all saw it. We were there. Just kidding. Well, Eve, it looks like majority rules. So Roman Reigns, come on down and get your gift. Which is me. Wow, fuck y'all. That job.
I was trying to get you six, baby. I'm sorry. I wanted six rings for you.
Yeah, man. We did that. Damn. We did that. That's some good shit, man. Big shout out to KP because everybody involved with putting this shit together, man.
Yes, you guys are literally the best.
Everybody, listeners' choice.
The listeners as well.
We got a team now, man. It's been, you know, going on for 4.5 years, and now the team is growing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
KP and because of this fucking Kyrie and LeBron when it comes to fucking production and shit like that. So they really help us make this shit move, and I want to give you guys a big thank you. You know what I'm saying, for producing this Brammy Awards, because you know without y'all, it wouldn't have been this happening.
And shout out to the listener's choice, except everyone, but the guy who voted for Edge in that Superstar of the Year category. Everybody except whoever that was. So amen. Thank you as well. What do we got next? We got Talk to Me Nice.
Well, you don't got no news and rumors?
Let's do it. I can hit the drop. I don't have any. But, Eve, I'm sure it's something you want to get off right now.
It's a couple news and a couple rumors I want to talk about.
Let's do it.
A little bit.
News and rumors.
All right, so hear me out. Here's the news and here's the rumors that I got, right? First news and first rumors. is this right here. Let me see if I can pull it up real quick. Because I seen with my own eyes some shit. You know what I'm saying? Let me see. Hold on. Let me go to Twitter real quick. Feel me?
Twitter.
Because I seen something from Matthew Hardy that made me say, Ah, yes. This right here. Hold on. Let me share the screen with y'all real quick. Share.
This nigga went back to church.
Can somebody read that for me, please?
I think teaming together and having one last run as a tag team would be. I can't. We're in the way.
Oh, hold on.
Can't move us out the way.
Put us on the side vertically. Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Look at me. Okay, I think us teaming together and having one last run as a tag team would be amazing. And I couldn't think of a better place to do it than All Elite Wrestling. That's what he wanted. That's what he wanted the whole time. Because Matthew is obviously lost in the shuffle over there.
Been lost. Yeah.
You know what I mean? His brother come over there, give him a little shot in the arm, shot up the card. Well, obviously he wants that.
That shit is insane. It also is crazy because what did I say on episode 208? Do y'all remember? You remember when I put on my tinfoil fucking hat? When he was like, yo, why would Jeff Hardy do some shit like this? You feel me? What is the reason? Hold on, I'm gonna share the screen. We sharing screens today. Let me share this screen with y'all. I got the footages. Hold on, I'm gonna share it with y'all.
This nigga got the footages. Who you, nigga?
TMZ.
Come on, I told you. I see this. I said I'm here to report live.
I'm looking at me.
Me too. Let's watch this shit real quick. Hold on.
At first, I'm like, "What you talking about? He's just on tour." You know what I mean? Like, nah. All right, I see what you
Jeff did. Jeff Hardy and the acoustics. Nigga, what? Acoustic what? Guitar? I don't want it. This nigga got... Bad fellas.
Oh, wait, I think it's right here.
Something's fishy, bro. Thumbs up, man. I don't know what it is. I put my tinfoil hat on just now. I don't know. Wait, I can't explain everything. I just know... Stop sharing my screen right there.
I ain't gonna hold you, man. For him to have the dates already set up and shit, it's like, yeah.
You looking crazy in the light, no?
Was this before? Like, did he have this plan while he was, like, why are you just ready to get dates? Right, I mean, I don't know, man. I ain't saying that.
Fans got released and then had a tour.
Thumbs up, man. I don't know what it is. I put my tip.
Where the fuck is it? I'm trying to find the shit where I said Matt Hardy embezzled his brother into leaving so that he could join him and they could win tag team championships in all promotions. I predicted this, you feel me? I said it right here on this show, you feel me? Episode 208 is somewhere around the hour 13 mark, you know what I'm saying? Go ahead and watch it. But I remember vividly saying that something's up, you know what I'm saying? Because Matt Hardy can't swim without Jeff Hardy. You feel me? That, his little brother, is his life jacket. That's his floaty. That's his support system. That's his lifeline. You feel me? Jeff could go and swim anywhere. You feel me? I'm litty. You know what I'm saying? I'm Gucci. I go anywhere. I could be popping. You know what I'm saying? Obviously not now, his old age, because, you know, your body, you feel me? You can't do that no more. But Matt Hardy, you selfish. You know what I'm saying? You know your brother can't take this shit no more. You know you by your body cannot do this no more. And you do. You feel me? You trying to sneak one more win in, just for the, you feel me? Just to say we got him in every promotion. But hey, man, shame on you, Matt Hardy.
This nigga Matt Hardy formulated this whole shit. Like, here's the plan. This is what you're gonna do.
Word.
Set this whole
Tony Khan say, man, nigga, if you don't put that bullshit drone down, he said, Jeff, you got to come here so I can pick my drone back up. You feel me? This nigga want to play with toys on TV. That's all. Hey, man, don't be tricked and don't be fooled by Matt Hardy and his jig.
I mean, damn!
You feel me? So that's one thing I wanted to say. Secondly,
Jim Ross. It has been reported Jim Ross came to Twitter. I'm going to share the screen with y'all. Hold on.
Snigga, Eve, your transition game is crazy. Just say that because I know what's happening, but like, Eve, that was crazy. All right.
You feel me? Look, we on to some happier news. You know what I'm saying? Jim Ross reported today, I'm cancer free. We did it. You know what I'm saying? Can we get a round of applause for Jim Ross for good old JR?
Aww.
Shout out to good old JR, man. He came back. He was on
Dynamite tonight.
Yeah.
Fire.
Yeah, no, that definitely this brought a smile to my face because obviously this holiday season, this whole year was, you know, it's been pretty pretty dark. And I remember when Jim Ross announced this, that's obviously it's not the news anybody wanted to hear, but I'm glad that he's now cancer free and, you know, we'll be able to see Jim Ross for some more time, you feel me, for longer. He, you know, he got life and he's able to live along, you feel me, a little bit longer. So salute to you, JR. I'm happy for you. I'm proud. What else do we got?
I'm happy in the hood.
Most definitely.
I got one. I thought of one right now.
What's that? Is it what I think it is?
Look, man, I knew it was over.
Hold on. I'm gonna share the screen. I know where you're going, brother.
I knew it was over.
It was 4 years.
Yep, here we go. I knew it was over, son. They had Shorty go on SmackDown, take two pies to the face, nigga. Two pies to the face. And she just stood there like, dog, make moves, nigga. You just got hit in the face twice. You sitting there like you about to cry. I was like, yo, ever since then, it's like, it's no coming. Like, me personally, I don't know how y'all other people wrestling fans be, but like, dog, I'm always remember you sitting there, no matter how hard you try to push somebody. It's like, dog, you getting hit in the face with two, not one, two, and you just looked at Charlotte, tap dance in your face and not do a goddamn thing. It was ever since then, I was like, nah, it's over. It's over. I don't know how this happened, by the way. Hold on. Let me get this clear too. I don't know what's going on, but either, like, this aside,
well, it's been reported she asked for her release and they granted it. So,
well, goddamn, congratulations to her. Well, goddamn. That's because, like, yo, it was over right then and there. It was over, son. It was over so much. It's like, because, like, a lot of things in wrestling, y'all try to be like, nah, just sit and wait. No, ain't no sitting waiting, my nigga. If you see some shit that ruins somebody, it's over. It's over, my nigga. No, yeah. We're not going to, the people, they got to think, like, our memory is not, like, we could remember some shit, my nigga, regardless of how you try to block it out. Like, nah, that's made her look like a complete dweeb, son. And Toni Storm is better than that. She's not like that type of wrestler where you could have her look this type of way. Like, she can go. She's talented. She deserves way more than that. So if they ever decided to push her moving forward and everything, it's not believable.
No, you're right. You're right. 100%. That's crazy.
That's a fact.
I'm going to transition real smoothly. this is the last of it. It's not really news and rumors. Well, it's news, but it's not really nothing to do with AEW, WWE. This has to do with us. So I'm gonna share the screen one more time. Just so everybody can see that, you know, the listeners, we wanted to bring out some Christmas presents as well. You know what I'm saying? Over here, we work hard on this side to make sure everybody happy in the hood. Word applies. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So we got here. I just want to make sure y'all tap into our website, theblackannouncetable.com. You feel me? It's up. It's running. You feel me? Make sure you check that out. Make sure you tap into that. You feel me? TBA, the Patreon, patreon.com/blackannouncetable. Well, I guess now's the time to say it. So we'll be starting in the new year. There will be more tiers, obviously. more content. So I'm gonna rattle it off right here so y'all know. You feel me? And so y'all go over there and subscribe because, you feel me, shit is getting good. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to have a $1 tier, $5 tier, $10 tier, and a $20 tier. $1 tier is just word to do Dr. Umar's donations. You feel me? You don't get none with the $1. If you just want to give us a dollar just because, so we all get 33 cents. You feel me? That's cool. You feel me? So I appreciate the donation. You know what I'm saying? The $5 tier will be audio and Discord access. You feel me? $10 tier will be audio and video, plus Discord access, and you get the podcast a day early. I'm not sure if y'all have noticed, but we've been recording the podcast on Wednesdays now. So Wednesday, usually it was Thursday, and we go up Friday. So now the format is we record Wednesday. We still drop on Fridays, but if you are tapped into the Patreon, you will get the episode on Thursdays. So you get the episode a day earlier. Right, so that's the $10 tier. The $20 tier, you get the audio, you get the video, the Discord access, the early podcast. You get to be a guest on the show on the Patreon episode with me or Cody and Banks or Chris, you know what I'm saying? And you get early access and discounts on merch. And yes, new merch is coming quarter one, you feel me? Surprise, surprise. So make sure y'all tap in. We feel me, we doing some things over here, you know. A lot, you feel, we working. A lot of things is coming. You feel me? Don't ever think we just sitting down, you feel me, on our ass not doing nothing. You feel me? We getting some things done on this side.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're wondering what kind of content is going up there, like I said, the TBAT radio will be weekly now. That's the, you feel me, why I'll drop it like an hour, 45 minute long, not an hour and 45, but 45 minutes to an hour long playlist. You know what I'm saying? So those been going up. We got A Story to Tell, which is a new series, I guess, that is going to premiere soon. It's going to be an animated series based off the stories that we've told on the podcast previously.
Flames.
Make sure y'all tap into that. Also, memes, GIFs. We're on Jiffy now. If you go on Jiffy.com or if you got the app, whatever the fuck it is, if you look our names up right here, I'm going to make it big and clear so y'all can see. If you look our names up, we will be on Jiffy. You know what I'm saying? You'll be able to download our GIFs from the show. I got a couple. Chrisanne got the most downloads right now. She hot in the streets. You know what I'm saying? Cody got some downloads, you feel me? So the Jiffy right now is popping. It's going up. So make sure y'all tap into that. And show some love and you feel me and use us as reactionary gifs, you know what I'm saying? And this right here, this is definitely what I wanted to get to. Because y'all fuck with us, you feel me? We want to show y'all that we fuck with y'all too. The Day One Fan Contest. We want to recognize the folks that rock with us, our top predictions champs and a few others. We get the opportunity to win a WWE championship belt with custom black announce table plates. You are Day One. And you deserve the best. And that is coming in February.
I'm jealous of y'all. Ooh. I'm jealous of the listeners. I want a damn belt too.
You feel me? So there's a lot coming. I'm telling y'all, you feel me? My word is my bond. You feel me? 2022 will be a good year. It's looking up. You feel me? I'm very optimistic about it.
Excellent year.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? A lot is going to come from 2022. Not only for us, but for you guys as well. So I want y'all to make sure y'all tap into the Patreon. Patreon, they get the most updates, you feel me, in the first update. So if you're not tapped in over there, please make sure you are. And if you're not tapped into the YouTube, make sure you subscribe over there as well. So I just wanted to share that before we move on to whatever it is we're about to move on to. What are we doing, TTMN?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's hit the drop and we'll jump over to
Talk to me nice.
All right, man. Just talk to me nice. We this is a calm episode. Not even calm. This is a great episode. You know what I'm saying? We're going to start how we always start, the last TTMN of the year. Let's start on Instagram. And then we're going to jump over to Twitter like we always do. So let's see here. Bet. Let me just drag this here. Let's start from right here. Shouts to Jermaine Avery. He said, TTMN, can we get a weekly flamethrower segment? Eve started something a few weeks ago, but Cody and Suku have had their rants as well. I love the show. I appreciate it, brother. A weekly flamethrower segment. I smoked Matt Hardy just now. I exposed him, you know what I'm saying? So I guess that was it just now. But I'm with the ether on the weekly, if y'all with it.
Well, man, it got to be something. It got to be something out there to provoke that emotion. I'm not. We don't force anything over here. But if it's something that gets us riled up, oh, best to believe it will be rants.
Yeah, I'm also sure that of the three of us, that one of us will have something to rant about on a weekly basis.
Out of the three, I'm probably the angriest, so most likely will be me.
You are definitely the angriest one. But,
for what reason? I have no idea.
Hey, man. You feel me?
For real. You should be happy. You live in Freeport. You got you a wonderful life. Lady.
My life isn't bad.
Look at your tie.
Word.
But, you know, people get on my nerves too, brother. You know what I'm saying? I don't got patience. Like y'all.
Gotta let that hurt go, Eve. You gotta let that hurt go.
I'm trying. Because he said, TTMN, who got the most lit gift this Christmas? My gift is right here. I can show y'all.
I would say Eve. I like Eve because that's an investment gift right there. The fresh mic. Like, come on, you can't beat that.
Oh, let me get it and show y'all real quick. Hold on.
My nigga Eve, y'all. That, ladies and gentlemen, that's Sky High Eve. I don't know if y'all know his name or whatever, but that's him right there. Yeah, man. But I'm pretty sure it's Eve. I'm not gonna say I don't wanna indulge too much of my gifts, but it's cool. You know what I'm saying? It's cool. I have to go with Eve. This nigga Eve went to get his shit.
Fuck you, nigga. I'm right here. This nigga always talking some shit.
Yeah, I mean, you know. I thought I could get some shit off real quick.
my mic stand is on the way. Amazon, y'all moving real slow. But, you know,
facts.
I got the official tissue microphone, you know what I'm saying? So my quality will be a lot better. And yeah, you know, I told y'all 2022. I'm going crazy, man. I'm really trying to smoke niggas out here in 2022. Niggas,
honestly, what I should have gotten this year was the gift of Wi-Fi, but
should have got you some fire, sister. I don't know what to tell you. Some fiber optics.
Listen, I wasn't gonna gift myself some fires. I thought somebody else would have gifted it to me, but I guess not. I guess I'll have to go get it myself.
It's funny because when you said that, you lagged. So you definitely need to.
I need that shit. I need that. You know what it is too, though? Like, my brother's kids are here. So 29/7, they're on their phone. They're on their iPad. They're on everything. They're on everything. Like, I'm always like, bruh, it's just two of y'all. Like, hello. But no, they're always on this shit. Wi-Fi juice. Bro.
Yeah, nah, this microphone is definitely probably the best Christmas gift I ever got because it's not a pointless gift. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely something to help me elevate what I do. It helps make the podcast better. So I'm excited about it. I'm excited to set this up and begin using it.
Especially with the shit you just named, all the tiers and shit we got going for the next year, man. That's a great investment.
Yeah, man. That's really all I've been, you feel me? You got to... I've been talking about it on Patreon.
And with the new segment that you'll be doing too, you know? You need the extra. Oh, yeah, the radio. Mm-hmm.
Man, we've had these mics for, I think, about a year and a half, almost 2 years. So it was definitely time for an upgrade.
And
these is really the best mics out, the most top-of-the-line mics. Y'all might see them in, like, a lot of podcasts. I know Gilly and Wallow use them. Charlamagne be using them on The Breakfast Club, The Radio. You feel me?
Yo, like, I was like, who is Willie?
I said Willie and Gallo, like
Gallo.
this juice got me twisted. I'm sorry.
Clearly.
Yeah, man, that microphone is definitely the best gift I have ever received. So
dope.
Yeah, man.
Nice.
Shouts to Sheena Ryan. She said, who do you think will be the next call-up from NXT 2.0 to the main roster? Hashtag TTMN.
You know, I tuned into NXT 2.0 yesterday. Mm-hmm. And for the first time in a long time. And let me tell you, that shit, I wasn't a fan of it. I was about to call it ass, but I'm not going to take it that far. But I wasn't really a big fan of it. What's his name? Grayson Waller. I see he getting a little, he getting a time. Like, they got AJ Styles over there fucking with him. It's looking like he about to be, it's looking like he about to be one of them ones that get called up soon.
The first call up. Should be Tommaso Ciampa, old ass. Now, you've been down there for 6 years. You need to get your ass up on the main roster and do some work. You need to stop running from the grind. You need to get your ass to SmackDown or Raw. You need to get to work immediately.
But what is the point for him to be like another Robert Roode, like just old and taking up space? Like, come on, no, bro.
Because you've only been on this show hiding for 6 damn years. You need to go up to the main roster and do something, nigga.
Ciampa told him, he was like, yo, if I go up to the main roster, I'm retiring. He told him, nigga, straight up.
Well, guess what, nigga? I guess it's time to call it quits.
But why?
Because we don't see you do everything in NXT under the sun.
Exactly. But that's what I'm saying. Like, why wouldn't you want to get called up? Like, why would you say, like, I'm going to retire if I get called up? Because
have you seen what ridiculous. They do to call ups then?
But it's just like it's the developmental brand. Like, how much longer do you need to fucking develop for? Why are you not fully grown yet, Tommaso?
He just like he's one of those people. It's those people that just want to be out there and wrestle. Like, he getting the opportunity. He know if he go up to the main roster, he gonna be chasing Reggie. He gonna be doing some shit. Like, he's not having fun. I guess it's. That's mainly for certain wrestlers like him. Like, these niggas, they just want to be out there type shit. Like, you go to that main roster, there's no future for Ciampa up there. Vince looking at, like, who is this nigga? He about to mop the floors? Like, what he about to do? Like,
who are these niggas?
So, I understand that. As far as the question, I have no clue. Because I'm not tapped in with 2.0 like that. I do see a lot of potential with people, though.
They said, wait, so what she said? Who do you think? I said, who should? Who do I think? I think it's going to be the Usos' younger brother. What's his name? Siku Samoa, whatever his name is.
Yeah.
Whatever. Hey, Cutie Samoa. Should be him.
Look.
What about your guy that you always talk about, though?
Siku Smith. You got me fucked up. Siku Smith.
What about your other guy that you always talk about?
Who, Carmelo Hayes?
Bron Breakker.
Yeah, Bron Breakker.
I think Bron gonna be the face of NXT, him and Melo. So I don't think he should come. I don't think he should be the first one to come up, but I think Bron right now he's the face of NXT 2.0, okay. I should say.
Cool.
Shouts to Kung Fu Eddie. Let's see what you gotta say.
Hello, Kung Fu Eddie here with another TTMN for this week. No question this week. Nothing's really happening other than Dynamite. That's the only thing I care about. Just want to wish you guys a happy new year. Thank you for the contact that you've been providing us. All the entertainment, the laughter, the knowledge, all that good stuff. I appreciate you guys continuing providing and connecting with your audience. As always, like they say in my country, salud para el nuevo año. You enjoy the rest of your week. Like I said, see you 2022.
Salud, bye-bye. Salud, salud.
Salud, Eddie.
Salud, Eddie. Thank you so much, bro.
Facts. Thank you, Eddie, for those lovely words. You feel me? I hope you have a happy new year as well. And I hope your Christmas was special. Let's see. Shouts to Just Vince. He said, TTMN with the latest release of Toni Storm, further thinning the SmackDown Women's roster. Who would you like to see Charlotte
face next?
Good question. Let me bring up that SmackDown damn roster, number one. See who up there. I think we almost, we got to get a Sasha and Charlotte match again. They got to re-rock that again. It's been a minute.
I honestly love every time they fight. Like, I just feel like they have such great chemistry. I'm always rolling. It's always a good time for me. So yikes. I would love that, as always.
Where's Shotzi at right now?
She was let on her, SmackDown. But I don't know where she been.
Wherever the hell she at, keep her in the one place. Because, no.
You want her to stay there?
Yeah, she came up and just, I don't know what it is. I ain't really check out like that at NXT, but dog, I ain't know she was this ass, my nigga. Didn't. She going up in the ring just fucking up shit. Like, damn, can you do a move properly? Like, I'm cool.
A lot of people liked her on NXT, though. Like, I know mad people was hype when she came up. And I was like...
Yeah, no, she was dope in NXT. Well, a lot of people is dope in NXT, you feel me? That's like being pop in high school. It's like, yeah, all right.
Yeah.
Who's not lit in high school? Then but you get to the real world, and niggas is like, you're fucking... You're 28. Why are you still wearing your high school varsity jacket?
Relax. Don't get at them niggas. They ain't do nothing to you, Eve. All right, man. The SmackDown women's roster, it has Aaliyah, Naomi, Natalya, Sasha, Shayna Baszler, Shotzi, and Xia Li. So
it's I would like to see Xia Li and Charlotte do something. That might be interesting. Xia Li could go.
She can. But for the championship? So soon? I mean...
No, look. Not so... Yeah, not I know so what you
soon,
mean.
But yeah, I know what you mean, too. So I'm with you. Not so soon, but I do want to see Xia and Charlotte go at it. Xia's my girl, too. I fuck with Xia.
Yeah, Xia's really good.
Look, man, they're going to have her doing some wild shit in a few months. I'm sure of it. She's going to be breakdancing, doing some wild shit in a few months. No, look, it's sad, but I...
Damn, man. Niggas just gonna be breakdancing. Let's jump over to Twitter and see what's popping over there. I already got everything pulled up, so this should be good. Let's see. Boom. Share.
See what's going on the Twitter.
All right.
Man, say he on the way, man. You ready? Like, yo, don't start this shit. I'm on the way.
Shouts to the homie Clay. I got to retweet that for the people. You know what I'm saying? Wait, first off, I think we got one from Donnie from last week that we didn't get to. Yeah, this one right here. He said, TTMN, because of the recent shenanigans, Cody and Eve, how does it feel to be parents now?
Oh, man, I know where this is going. I ain't saying nothing. Yo, man.
Those ain't your sons?
Fifth annual Brammy Award. That's all I got to say. Go with yours if you have something to say.
Fuck them niggas. Anyways. Shouts to insert username. He said, what are your goals for the show next year? Hashtag TTMN.
Me personally, just growing the viewership, listenership, just having more people rocking with us. Like I said, the extra, like, dog, we started this. Me personally, I just wanted a platform where I could talk wrestling. You know what I'm saying? That's all. The extra, everything that comes with it is extra for me. So that's all for me. I just want more people listening, more people tapped in. Simple. That's all.
Oh, that's nice. Well, I want some money, so a sponsorship would be great. So that's what I want for next year, so that we can get some money.
Matter of fact, I know the perfect thing to play for this. Hold on. Because this is everything I want in one.
Oh, let me see if I can find it real quick.
Take a seat.
Hold on, we just gotta get through this this ad real quick. There we go. Man, look.
I mean, that's obvious. Obviously, we ain't doing this shit. Come on, man.
I need money, power, and respect. In 2022, you niggas will give me money, I'ma have the power, and y'all gonna give me my damn respect. Because we going on 5 years of this shit, and we ain't stopping. You understand me?
So I'm 5 years of this.
Five. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. You feel me? We going on 5 years. So I need money, I need power, and I need respect. And that's what I'm going to get. You know what I'm saying? By all means, I'm here to put my foot in niggas' necks. You feel me? I'm about to go crazy. Y'all seen the microphone I got? I'm about to wild out in 2022. You feel me? The Patreon going up. The money on the Patreon going up. We getting merch out. You feel me? We busting links.
Nigga talking over the beat.
I'm doing interviews. I'm doing all time. Everything I want to do, I'm going to do. You know what I'm saying? And nobody's going to stop me. You feel me? We got one of the best shows out right now. Y'all seen the beginning of the shit? It said number one. You know what I'm saying? So
the shit said number one, man.
The shit says number one. The number one wrestling pod. So with that being said, we're going to continue to stay number one at the top of the mountain. You know what I'm saying? We're going to get better. We're going to get cheddar. And we're going to get respect. You know what I'm saying? So that's all I want. The Patreon going to go up. The subs on the YouTube going to go up. I want some fucking plaques. And I want a Spotify deal.
Speaking into existence.
Yeah. KP, if you see that, clip that and use that as a, you feel me? If you don't use it, send it to me, because that shit was hot. I know it. Shouts to Uncle Rock. He said, TTMN, no question. I just wanted to say, I live y'all. This guy. It's like, nah. I just wanted to say I love y'all and I'm proud of y'all. This has been a great year, and I'm looking forward to many more. Congratulations to the family. Hashtag BAT, hashtag BRP. Uncle Rock, I appreciate you, brother. Thank you so much. Hey, man, shouts to everybody that rock with us heavy. You know what I'm saying? That, you feel me? The troops, you know what I'm saying? Rock, peeps, you feel me? Roy, everybody, man. Like, everybody in the Discord, you feel me? Salute to y'all, man. Y'all really out of family, man. So shouts to y'all. Shouts to Donnie. Let's see what Donnie got to say. He said, TTMN, Happy New Year's family. Two questions. One, who is your overall loser of the year? That's what we should have had in the next year. We're going to have that. Who's your overall loser of the year? And two, what are some things that you want to improve or get better at in 2022?
Finn Balor is the overall loser of the year, so.
Damn.
You know why?
It's because he keep doing that demon shit. That's why.
Because this nigga, man, he was in NXT, shining, doing his thing, came up, turned into the demon, fell off the ropes. Niggas just doing some loser shit. Like, you, Finn, what happened, my nigga? You was in NXT wilding. You had one of the illest turn on the niggas, gave a nigga the Pele kick, turned on the niggas you was rolling with. Each star, I'm like, yo, Finn on his shit, nigga. Came to the main roster, losing, nigga. L's, nigga. On top of L's, nigga. L's anthem, Lil Durk. Losing, like, bro, why are you such a loser all of a sudden?
Yeah.
I just feel like it's just a different vibe. It's a different, like, group of people. It's, you know, different, like, weight class. Like, there's just bigger dudes, like, on the main roster, you know what I mean? Compared to, you know, other, like, smaller men like him, you know, on NXT. But he was still really just putting on an NXT anyway. I don't know. I think it's like a curse.
That nigga's a loser.
At this point. He's not a loser. I don't say that about him. But he is the overall loser of the year. I would agree with that.
He fell off the ropes. The rope snapped. You are a loser. And nigga came out and we ain't getting no explanation. Like, niggas don't even care after that shit. Like, you a loser. We just gonna keep it pushing. We ain't even hit.
Because that shit was too embarrassing.
This nigga is a yo, Finn Balor sucks.
I think the overall loser of 2021 is Andrade. This man cannot read. He lost his job. He quit his job because he wasn't being used. Just so he could go to AEW and they could not use him some more. So not only can you not read, but you are the biggest loser of this year, and you lost your fiance as well. So you losing everything. You feel me? You losing your pride.
Yo.
You losing your minutes to your matches. You losing TV time. I'm sure you lost money. You lost Ric Flair because he's out of here.
He lost who? His fiance?
Mm-hmm.
Nah, they right here.
Yeah, when did they break up? I didn't hear that.
They right here.
Chief. Oh, I thought they split. Put that on the big screen. Hold on.
They right here, Chief.
When was that? Today?
Oh,
Christmas. Damn, well, I guess he ain't lose his girl.
Christmas, okay. Look at you, Eve. Ready to flame this man. So he is not.
I was digging that grave.
You already say he can't read.
You need to prove me wrong.
Saying nigga can't read. Like, that is always funny to me.
Well, what that
I'm sure you can read in Spanish.
That don't count. What did 50 Cent say to Floyd? If you can read a page out of his
head, read a page.
That's why that shit's so funny. Like, making fun of niggas that can't read is hilarious, bro. That shit is funny.
Nah, that shit was hilarious when 50 said that about Floyd, though.
If you could read one page out of this Harry Potter book, I'd do this Ice Bucket ALS ILC challenge.
Then they said this shit wrong. Nobody even cared he said this shit wrong. It was just so funny.
That, more than the second part. What are some things that you want to improve or get better at in 2022?
Well, there's always room for improvement. I feel like, you know, just having a better, way of navigating the show. I feel like this year, although we did have a lot of, you know, like great opportunities that, you know, came out of us having to do this remote, you know, it's still sometimes, you know, we're still working on perfecting this. So, you know, that's definitely one thing, at least on my, for me, that I would like to, you know, see the show come together better and, you know, like for me to get better Wi-Fi and shit like that. Like just small things, you know, like little tweaks, because I feel like overall the concept is there and that's like our foundation, you know what I mean? But like, yeah, it's just small things that, you know, we could always improve and work on. Like Eve said, you know, us trying to get better equipment. Eve also mentioned in the past about us getting like certain type of cameras. You know what I mean? Like just small things like that, that I feel like would be great toward the overall product. So yeah, I still want all of those things.
Yeah. And look, just to piggyback off of what you said, this is I just want to, this is, of course, this is our baby, you know what I'm saying? And we're not doing it together anymore. We're doing it from, you know, home, but I still want it to be the best that it can be, not only for us, but for the people that listen to it, you know what I'm saying? So I want to have the best microphone so I sound good when I record for you guys. I want to have the best interface. I want to, you feel me? I got fucking lights and everything set up. I want to look good and be good for you guys. You know what I'm saying? I want to start doing some interviews. You know what I'm saying? That's something we haven't really done. It's something I don't know how to do, but it's something I want to do, and I want to, you know, get good at it. And I want to give it a shot. You know what I'm saying? So interviews is something I want to try and, you know, to do in 2022. I want to, you know, get some better equipment. Not that the equipment I got right now is garbage, because it's not. But, you know, I want to get a little better camera. You feel me? I want to look good and put the best quality out. You know what I'm saying? Just because, why not? If we say we the best, how can I not put out the best? You feel me? So it's like, I really want to push myself to be the best at this shit in every single way, whether it's the sound, whether it's how it looks, you know what I'm saying? Whatever it is, I can make it the best. I want to try and make it the best for real. So, yeah, you know?
Yeah. For me personally, just overall planning of the show and managing my time in different ways. Like, I want to get the show, I want to come in here more prepared to talk about things for the show. Like, I feel like, me personally, I feel like I can do, even though I do a good job, but I feel like it's more. I want to be tapped in more. Like, I do a show. We got these listeners and everything. I want to come in fully prepared. It's like stuff some of the time it's like stuff I don't even be watching and shit. It's just like, you know what I'm saying? And I don't even feel like talking about it. One thing about me, if I'm not fully informed about something, I don't like talking about it. You know what I'm saying? It's like a lot of podcasters and stuff nowadays, people just mention shit and to give opinions on shit they know nothing about. You know what I'm saying? I feel like that's a lot about social media and everything like that. People just have opinions, so quick to throw out an opinion, but know nothing about the shit. I feel like with our show, we give out opinions and stuff. I could be a little more tapped in to give better opinions and stuff like that. Besides that, manage my time correctly with the show and putting out extra content and stuff. Just continue banging shit out. That's all. Just getting better, consistently banging shit out. That's all.
I agree.
Yeah.
We got some shouts to Click. Click two times, the real two times on Twitter. Let's see what he got to say. Hold on. I got to roll the footage back. Hold on.
Just a comment.
Oh, real quick. Click is definitely our TTMN holder. You are, if we're giving out awards, I want to give you your award for TTMN. You feel me? You've had three of these like video TTMNs this year, but they have all been hilarious. You know what I'm saying? We definitely encourage y'all to send some, you feel me? Send some of these in for sure. Or voice notes on our IG, whatever it is, but just these like are that. Definitely appreciated.
Yep.
So let's see what Click got to say. Hold on.
Black announce table. Aloysius Skipper Jenkins III, AKA Click two times. I got 2 points I would like to make. Number one, how do y'all feel about Toni Storm getting Futured Endeavored? Milkmen are down one. I know they're sad that those vanilla cakes won't be on their TV screen. But it's WWE we're talking about here. Number two, not a question, just a comment. No, you know what? It is a question. Black announce table, all three of y'all, 1, 2, 3. How does it feel to be the dopest wrestling podcast ever?
Aww.
I mean it. You guys have brought me so much joy, so much entertainment that I want to give you guys something. A late Christmas present, if you will. So the next video you see that's not hashtag aesthetics will be a commercial for your Patreon. Hashtag spend the five, if y'all don't mind. If y'all want to play it, cool. If you don't want to play it, that's fine, too. You know what I mean? I'm going to send it to your inbox, actually. Yeah, I'm going to send it to your inbox. So it's going to be a video of me doing a commercial for your Patreon. If you want to use it, fine. If you don't want to use it, that's cool, too. But that is my gift to the Black Announce Table because I'm broke. I can't actually get y'all something to fuck. I'm not made of money. Anyway, Aloysius Skipper Jenkins III, a.k.a. Click two times. You got to say...
Hey man, Click.
Aw, Click. Thank you. What a guy.
Appreciate that, big dog.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm gonna play this this video.
Yeah,
right,
play
here.
It.
You gonna play this live? Hold on. Hold on, my brother. You know what I'm saying? Oh, let's see.
Yo, play the video.
I'm trying to, nigga. My Wi-Fi acting. My Wi-Fi box not working. Hold on.
My Wi-Fi heard all the shit your Wi-Fi been talking about.
Hold on.
Nigga, Wi-Fi weak.
This shit dookie. Hold on. Let me see if I can play something else. If I can play this, my Wi-Fi Gucci.
Storm quit. Fired. Shouts out to Dave Meltzer. Nigga said Storm quit, not fired. Like, damn, nigga. I mean, wow.
When he gonna quit?
That's OD.
Black announce table!
Oh, God damn.
Aloysius Skipper Jenkins III, a.k.a. Click two times. Yes! I would like to be a part of your award show.
I don't even know what the awards are for, but I should be a part of it. I should announce.
What the fuck?
What happened?
I don't know. Hold on.
Hell versus Skipper James the Third, aka Click Two Times. Yes, I would like to be a part of your award show. I don't even know what the awards are for, but I should be a part of it. I should announce some award. I should announce something. Because that's what I do. I'm a commentator. I'm an announcer. That's what I do. I get paid to talk. You are talking about the new Jimmy Hart, the mouse of the South, baby. I'll let you know.
This is crazy. Hold on.
Bankane.
Fire.
That's funny because you literally, before I even watched this, I gave you your award for TTMN Hall of Fame. You know what I'm saying? So
well deserved.
Can we get a round of applause for Click, please?
Yeah, we got hit him with a round of applause, man.
My brother with another round of applause, man. He deserves it. Man, look, those are our last TTMNs of 2021. Woo! What a fucking year it's been. It has not been easy, but we've made it. You know what I'm saying? Obviously, it's not the same, but we still damn good. You know what I'm saying? And I'm proud of us.
Amen.
Hey, look, the change wasn't easy, but I told y'all in the last episode that we did all together that, you know, it was going to be different, but, you know, it's still going to be fire. And if this Brammy episode, this fifth annual Brammy, don't prove nothing else, it shows you that I'm right. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't lying. You know what I'm saying? It's not the same. But
I knew he was going to say that.
It's fire. You know what I'm saying? We have this right here is the best end of the year show, the best award show. You know what I'm saying? We all
bust our ass. It's just the best show.
That, you know what I'm saying? We number one. He said it. You know what I'm saying? Click said it in the thing. You know what I'm saying? So definitely we give you guys, you feel me? Give you guys your pats on your back. You know what I'm saying? Definitely pat yourselves on the back. Because you deserve that. And yeah, let's keep doing good. Let's keep running it up. Y'all see what I'm out here doing for y'all? I got on a suit and tie. You know what I'm saying? I came to report today.
Basketball shorts.
You feel y'all don't know. You feel me? Grab my flex. It's mysterious, you know? But yeah, man, we had a dope year. I'm looking forward to next year and everything that it brings. I hope we just run it up, man. I want some more success for us, so let's work. You know what I'm saying?
Period.
That being said,
I give my all.
Yes, sir, man. For the last time of the year, it's your boy Cody Dre. You can follow me on Twitter, social media, all that good stuff at Cody Dre, CODIEDRE. For this year, man, shouts out to the listeners, YouTube viewership, everybody that's been rocking with us. Just thank you. Thank you so much for your support and everything. Don't know what the future holds, but we're going to continue to give you that content, continue to be there, continue to be on y'all asses with this shit, and continue to knock y'all in the head with this dope ass shit, man. Y'all already know what it is. I catch y'all next year. Y'all know what it is.
Cody Dre.
And it's your girl, I'm Miss Suku. You can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, all that good stuff. I'm Miss Suku. You know, brand new things coming, you know, 2022. I just hope that everyone ends the year on a safe note. Stay inside, put your masks on, get boosted, get tested, you know, take care of your loved ones. If anything, these past 2 years have taught us is just that life is short, time is precious, and make the most of that shit. And you already know, it's the Tribal Princess, and I'll holla at y'all in 2022.
Ow.
And thank you guys for everything. Seriously, for everything. Like, the Patreon support, the support with the merch, the support with just every single thing, and, you know, the new listeners, everyone that's been, you know, rocking with us. We just appreciate you guys so much. Like, literally none of this is possible without you guys. So I look forward to just next year, another year of, you know, new people and everything. Laughs, fun times, maybe some live shows, maybe some live, you know, events, hopefully.
Mm-hmm. From your lips to God's ears, man. We gonna make it happen. Look, before I get out of here, please, well, you know, I'll add on to the shout-out. Shout-outs to, of course, the listeners. Shout-outs to all the guests that we had on the show this year. You know what I'm saying? Meals and J5, salute to the A-Show, Public Enemies, BRP, Rosenberg, Cass, Mouse Jones, those wrestling girls, to name a few. Salute to you guys, man. You guys had dope years as well. And, of course, it's not going to be the last time we have y'all on the show or run into y'all. So, salute to you guys as well. Thank you guys for being on the show this year. And, yeah, make sure y'all tap into the Patreon. Like I said, there's a lot of new stuff coming soon. Like I said earlier in the episode, there's giveaways. There's content. So patreon.com/blackannouncetable. Spend the $5, spend the $20, spend the $10. Or if you want to donate, you can spend the $1. You know what I'm saying? So make sure you go over there. Go over to the YouTube as well. YouTube.com/blackannouncetable. Subscribe. Like, share it. Turn the notifications on. Do everything you can. Comment. Do it all. You know what I'm saying? So do that. You can follow us on Twitter at BlackAnNCTable, on Instagram at BlackAnnounceTable. You can follow me, as is she right there, on Twitter and Instagram at Sky Haif. This your boy, Bishop TD Sycamore, the certified good youth, the one, Allen Ivermectin, Eve Luch, Mr. 200, Playboy Yachty, Eve LaFleur, the Derek Jeter of podcasting. But most importantly, I'm Mr. AKA. And bitch, if you act up, let that AK spray.
I love you, Eve.
Episode 210. I think we taking 2 weeks off in January. Obviously, Cody will be on vacation. I will be on vacation. So we will be back on, I'll give you the date. Let me see. Because I don't want to leave y'all hanging. You know what I'm saying? We'll be back on the 22nd.
Ooh. Damn. Y'all know January is a long-ass month, so.
Yeah, so.
Big January.
Don't worry.
We're coming back on January 22nd, and there's still 6 weeks left in January, so you will
be just fine. You know what I'm saying? And hold on. Let them know that Patreon.
What happened?
That Patreon will still be lit.
Oh yeah, no, the Patreon gonna be jumping while we're gone. Yeah. You feel me? So if you want the content, there will be more content going up over there. So you feel me? As of, you know, for right now, we're gonna take a little sabbatical for 2 weeks, rest, come back, and we're gonna knock y'all over the head with that good stuff. You know what I'm saying? So
yes,
until the 22nd, y'all be safe. January 22nd.
October 22nd.
I did. I could until the 22nd, but until January 22nd, y'all please be safe. Have a happy and healthy new year. Like Chris said, stay inside, get your booster, get your test. Just be safe. You feel me? We don't want to lose nobody. We need you guys. So do everything you can to stay safe, man.